Hello guys, welcome to the channel. In this video, I will tell you about an easy example of Proteus software to build a blinking of LED using Arduino UNO board. First, we have to open the Proteus software. Then in the components, you have to select the Arduino UNO board. After selecting the Arduino UNO board, we have to select the LED red. After selecting the LED, we have to select the resistor to manage the power of the circuit. Then we have to place as I shown in the diagram. First, you have to place the Arduino and LED red. After that, you have to place the resistor. Then connect the Arduino board to the resistor and that resistor other end to the LED red, and we have to place the ground. And from ground to other end of the LED, watch this carefully and do this experiment successfully. We have to keep the wire straight. We should not have any distractions while connecting the wires. We should cleanly observe and connect the wires respectively. Then I am opening the Arduino UNO software. The software name is Arduino IDE. I will open this and I will go to examples. In this example, we have the code of blinking of LED. Then go to digital and blink without delay. Yeah, this is the code for Arduino to blink an LED without delay. Once observe the code, if LED state is equal to low, LED state is equal to high. Else, LED state is equal to low, then delay. Means it gives the output to the pin number 13. Then I will save it as blink without delay. After saving this, we have to run the code. After it is telling the bytes and local variables, if the code is run successfully, then we have to go to scratch and export to binary. Yeah, it is run successfully, leaves the maximum of 2048 bytes. Then we have to double tap the Arduino UNO board in the Proteus software, and there one file folder is there. Then go to where the file you have stored. I have stored in my PC. Then all files YT blink without delay. I shown you back blink without delay, blink of LED with boot. Blink of LED bootloader hex file. We have to save and then open the file. Then we have to run the code. As shown in the circuit diagram, the LED D1 diode has blowing successfully. Means the code and the project has been successfully completed. Then we can add n number of LEDs to the project. For example, I am adding LED yellow and LED green to show you a basic traffic light example, and I am connecting with respectively to pin number 13 output, and we have to give ground compulsory. It is mandatory to give ground to run a code successfully. It is running successfully when we give the ground. We can take the ground and we can manage with one ground also. With the help of this video, you can do the project without any delay and without any disturbances. Thanks for watching the video. Like, share and subscribe the channel. Don't forget to activate the bell icon for latest updates. Thank you.